Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to add a progress bar inside of Camtasia 2024. It's quick and easy, so it's not going to take much time, but let's go ahead and dive in. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo. If you have Camtasia 2024, you can follow along here. I just have a simple recording. This is just a recording of a screen as I'm walking through and doing a demo here. If I want to add a progress bar, what I need to do is go into the media bin and then go into my assets. And this is part of 2024. You can access the media assets right there. If I go into the media assets, what I need to do is come down to where it says audio visualizers. If I see the audio visualizers, all I have to do from here is go ahead and click on see all. Audio visualizers allow me to add something that will adapt and fluctuate based on the audio. If you have some music and you want these to just kind of bounce to the audio, you can add something like an audio visualizer. But there are also a couple of other options that we have. So if I scroll down here, you'll notice that we run into these progress bars. Now there are three different types of progress bars. So let's go ahead and see what we can do with these progress bars. I'm just going to drag them onto my canvas for now. So I'll take this, drag it here, and you'll notice it will download the progress bar. And I can't see it right away. I need to move my playhead back and forth in order to see that. Now this is very small and it's kind of in the middle of the screen here. So what I'm going to do is drag this down to the bottom. Then I could just select one of the edges and just make this a little bit bigger. Now, if I just select one of the edges and don't do anything else, it's actually going to try to keep it proportional. If you don't want that, you don't want it to be that size, all you have to do is hold down the shift button before you click and drag, and you can adjust the size without having it adjust both the height and the width at the same time. Holding down the shift button allows you to also adjust the height here, and you can get it exactly how you want. Now, the progress bar will run for as long as you put it here. So if you want it to run for the entire length of your video, all you have to do is go ahead and move that and adjust it so it is the length of your video. Or if you just want it to be for a portion of your video, you can come in and then adjust it for a portion. A lot of the times that would be like, hey, I'm going to show you how to do something in 2 minutes and let's go ahead and start the timer right now. That's probably one of the reasons why you'd want to add a progress bar later in your video. I'm going to drag this back out here, and there's a couple things that I can do with my properties visible. If you don't see your properties, make sure you select your properties over on the right hand side. But with my properties visible and with this selected, I see my dynamic properties. This allows me to change the color, the background, and adjust the opacity of the background as well. I can come in here and adjust this color to, let's say, a Learning Dojo color that I have. Or you can add like a custom hex value if you wanted to, but that's just one of the colors I have available. Let me select that again. And then I can adjust the background color. Now the background color we really don't see right now because the opacity is set to zero. So we need to up that a little bit before we actually start to see the background color. If I want this to be a completely different color, I can, or you can just leave that as black and just have that kind of a transparent background there. Or you don't have to have a background there, that's up to you. That is how you do the basic one. Let's go ahead and get rid of that one. And so let's talk about adding a gradient one. This pretty much is exactly the same thing, but instead of just one color, we have two colors to adjust. And you can see as I start to move this, there's the gradient from top and here's the bottom color. So if you want to add a little bit of a gradient to your bar, you can do it this way and you still have the background color right there. That's the only difference with that one. This one is the progress bar looped. And let's go ahead and move this and you'll notice how it starts to kind of flash and loop. So you can have this kind of animate within the progress bar. And all you need to do here is also adjust the color one and color two. Color one will be the main color. Color two is going to be that moving flashing color as well. So if you want something like that, you can, instead of having it white on green, you can have it just slightly lighter green. And so it's not as flashy as what we're seeing here. So that is another option with the progress bar, but there's one more thing I wanted to talk about, and this is the range counter. So in the range counter, this actually counts up or counts down, and I can't really see it here because it's kind of white on white. So let's move it over here, and you can see that it will actually count, and it's going to count to 100 right here, and I can adjust that in the properties, and I don't know if that's per second or so, because watch when I like adjust that, it's not necessarily counting to 100 and it's not 100 seconds. This really is only 16 seconds, but it's going from 0 to 100 within that 16 seconds. So if I wanted this to be 0 to 16, and I wanted it to be exactly seconds, like counting seconds, I would come in here and adjust the endpoint to be 16. Now it'll be more kind of true to its time. So you have 1, 2, 3, and so forth. If you wanted to have it go faster, you could have the range go through a larger amount of numbers, or if you wanted it to go the number of seconds, you just have to match it to whatever length that you actually have it there. Those are a couple of different ways to be able to visualize progress to the learner. Progress inside of the video, you can do that with a progress bar, or you can do this with the range counter. You do not need to have the premium license in Camtasia in order to take advantage of these. Anything that does say premium, you will have to have a premium license. But in this case, these do not say premium, and some of the other audio visualizers do not say premium, and so you can just take advantage of those as well. If you want to see more of this, head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all my previous blog posts covering anything learning development related. You can also download free templates and then check out full courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to create these videos for you to really accomplish my goal to make you the best learning developer that you can be, taking advantage of different tips and tricks inside of the various tools. But that's all I have for today, so thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.